Hallo YouTube en hallo to my dear subscribers. Een nieuwe video van Kaarda. Ja, what a shame of yesterday's video, man. I mean, I was so in the zone while making that video. I was really, really in the zone. I love rambling about games and stuff anyway. And I was like, yeah, I can retake that video. But it's never gonna be the same quality as when you're recording. It's never as good as the original. But I'm gonna retry it. I made such a stupid mistake yesterday with the microphone. I'll tell you shortly what happened. This was not a microphone. I think you could hear that. it was unedible. If that's the correct English word. I know what I said, but I could only understand 50% myself. So if you got the essence, at least you got, you know what games I bought. But I know, man, there was static noise and so it wasn't this microphone. Did you know what was the microphone? This was the microphone. These two, they were the micro. I switched them around. Microphone was headset. This was the headset. The loudspeaker, and this was recording. These things were recording. That explains a lot. So now I checked, and this thing is actually now recording. It should be, this should be it. So we're gonna try it again. I'm gonna call it take two or something, and hope for the best. If you managed to struggle through yesterday's video, well, like I mentioned, I was in the zone, man. And I was like, yeah, if I'm gonna recapture, it's never gonna be this good. But the audio, man, I tried to fix it with OBS and other stuff. With Audacity, and I tried to do stuff with, at least you get more more mid-tones, but it wasn't so. These things were recording. And, well, they are not made for recording, especially when they're covered on top of your ears. So we're gonna try it again. Yeah. Where to start? I bought Switch. I think that's the best way maybe to start. Well, at least let's start with the people who commented. Hey guys, on yesterday's video, thank you very much, everybody, man. Christopher Richardson, I understand, man. All your quality was notwithstanding. I understand. And thank you for the comment. Good to be back. Solution 66, cardio back. Thank you, man. Padoka, hey man, good to see you. Oh, I'll see you on Attica stream, man. Christopher Ross, one of the old days. I think Christopher was the one who sent me that Legends of Leo Heroes. I was talking, yeah, nobody got to the end to hear it. Christopher Ross, man, you're awesome. Thank you again, man, for the Legends of Heroes. Anthony Jenkins, thank you very much. Glad to see you back. Super Vega 25 returns. Well, Carla returns as well. Yeah, Carla, you're back. We missed you. And we see your face again, yeah, man. Carla, do this. Oh, yeah, Terrison, I know you. Are they selling switches there? Lightning should start down. And Machiavelli, thank you as well, man. Good to see you. It's been a while, eh? Yeah. Oh my god, when are you gonna stream again? Yeah, that's gonna take a while. Send me mentions to me if you like. Yeah, I will them. I definitely will, Machiavelli. I'll definitely will not message you on the Epic Game Store because I'm not. Oh my. How to make this a very short ramble. I'm not going to install the Epic Game Store. It's a console war now on PC going on. And I'm sticking with Steam. So, no Borderlands 3, no Outer Worlds, no... What was the other games? Phoenix Point, man. I was looking for Phoenix Point. They sold out their backers. And there's another one. The first one, Metro. But Metro was a bit meh. But Phoenix Point... And Outer Worlds, I just gotta wait a year longer. We can go RR and pirate the hell out of those games, but I'm not gonna do that. I mean, I got a stack of Switch games here. I can afford not buying a PC game this year, man. And well, the good thing is Cyberpunk 2077, thank goodness, isn't going for Epic exclusively because, yeah, they own GOG, so they even if they want to, they're not gonna sell out their own GOG platform. So Cyberpunk, at least we got Cyberpunk. And the rest, I just, I'll just run away a year and buy it on sale on Steam. And I hope more people will not install Epic Game Store on the PC. This is not competition. So that's enough ranting, because I made a statement. I'm not going to install Epic Game Store. Whatever happens. I actually removed, I played Fortnite last year for a bit. And after all this controversy about they are spying on your DLL files, man, it's incredible that Epic Game Store. So I checked if I really, really removed all that stuff from Epic Game Store. It's all gone from my PC, thank goodness. I don't want it back. But the most reason is that's not, they are not promoting competition. They are only promoting exclusivity by, yeah, okay. But let's talk about Switch. Maybe that's why you're here, maybe not. If you like Bramble, you're welcome as well. 3 weeks ago, I bought that Switch, man. And what better time to step in the Switch than now? I mean, when it got released, what did we have? Zelda. I never been a big Zelda fan, so when it got released, and it's 2 years ago now, so happy birthday Switch, I mean, wow. We got Zelda, well, it was about €400 for the console and €100 for a memory card, and then on top of that you want a game, that's €600 and you got one game. So I didn't buy the Switch then. But 3 weeks ago, I had a little, let's say, tax return. So I had some money to spend. And I checked some video from Neo Games Park. He's a YouTuber. He doesn't make a video every day. Mostly once a week or 2 weeks. And he's from the United States. And he makes very nice impressions. He loves JRPGs. And I was a series of... I was like, okay, let's check out. Is Xenoblade Chronicles 2 worth the money? Is it good compared to one? So I watched his, he made 3 videos about Xenoblade Chronicles 2. I was like, yeah, I checked, and well, there's a bit of good lineup already for the Switch after 2 years. I was like, yeah, let's buy the Switch. So I bought the Switch in the combi package with screen protector, 64 gigabit memory card, and one game. And the game is Pokemon Go Pikachu. I could choose between Zelda and Pokemon. And I picked Pokemon. I shouldn't have. But that's for later. And that's what I bought. And I bought one game directly when I was in the store. I said I want the Pokemon edition then. But, well, it's not an edition. It's bonus price. But it's not a special edition bonus cover and Pokemon stuff on the Switch itself. And I bought one game, and that's Xenoblade Chronicles 2. So those are the two games I basically bought when I bought the Switch. It's the combi with Pokemon Go and Xenoblade Chronicles 2. And the first game I started up, because my first handheld was the Game Boy. I think it was Color or Advance. What, which one was the yellow? Was that, was Color, right? Game Boy Color Yellow with the Pikachu edition. That's the first handheld I had. And now I'm going to the Switch. I was like, hey, I want that remake of that old Pokemon. And now, but now I got the Switch. And I started the Switch with Pokemon, and I was blown away. It's for me, the Switch is a handheld. Let's say that first. It is console. I can connect it to the TV if I like, but I don't like. I like this thing as a handheld, and it's. And no, I'm not gonna. I'm not playing Skyrim all day on the toilet. I love that joke, by the way. Padoka. It's the best handheld. I mean, the Vita days for me are over now. It's incredible. And if you watch me from way back then, when I had my long hair here, it was awful. I used to start with PlayStation Portable and DS. Those were the handhelds. And I always was a PlayStation Portable fan. And then we got the Vita and the 3DS. And for me, the handheld of preference is the Vita. it's especially the resolution and the pixel size is so much better than the 3DS. And a good example is Virtua's Last Reward. I bought that game twice, once on the Vita and once on the 3DS. And on the Vita, it looks, because of the resolution, there are so many more pixels. Well, it's the 3DS. It's 400 pixels by 240 pixels like this. It's nothing. It's good for 2D. It's good for sprites and 2D games, but 3D looks horrible on the DS and on the 3DS. It's not made for 3D games, to my opinion. So when you compare Virtua's Last Reward, if you play it, if you can buy it on the Vita. To my opinion, it's the resolution. So I was always PlayStation Portable, Vita, and I hate the 3DS, but I do love the games that were on it. I mean, there were some very good games on the DS as well. But if it's not 2D, like that, what was? Yeah, I'm gonna repeat the video of yesterday. But it's true. What was it? Final Fantasy 4 or 6? They made in 3D on the DS. It looked horrible, man. Don't go 3D video games on the 3DS or the DS. But okay, it's how it is. And now I'm Nintendo, man. I'm told I'm all Nintendo. This is the future. And Xbox and PlayStation fanboys calling the Switch a lazy ass weak tablet. Yeah, they are right. It is a weak ass tablet, but this thing has games and exclusives. Not that PlayStation doesn't have that, or Xbox. Let's not start about Xbox. But this thing has games, man. I got games here. I can play 3 years now, and it's all the games that I like, you know, or maybe we like. I mean, I'm not into Metroid games. I'm not, well, there are still Axiom Verge, if you like that. They are still good, but I'm not in fighting or racing or shooting much. I like those RPG games, and the Switch, it's selling like hotcakes. So there is a market for developers to start producing good games, and they are. There's still another good thing. There's still a lot of physical. Not everything, which is a shame. But most is still physical, and I hope keep doing this. I'm not gonna go for Google Stadium. I'm not going for Xbox Live streaming, xCloud stuff. I'm not going for PlayStation, whatever it's called over there. For me, I want physical. It's my stuff. This is mine, you know. I'm not renting stuff. No, this is mine. And if I want to sell it, but I never will. But if I want to sell it, I bring it back to the store, or put it on marketplace or whatever. You know, this. I want physical. It's mine. You know what I mean. So, thumbs up for the Switch, man. And if you play most physical, do you need an extra memory card of 64 gig? I don't think so. You get 32, so 64 on top of it makes it 100. I think 32, if you buy most physical, should be enough. Most games that we like aren't like 40 or 60 gigabyte. It doesn't need to run GTA 5, you know? It doesn't need to have a game of 75 gigabyte. But if you only play digital, yeah, you really gonna need a good memory card. So yeah, for me, last 3 weeks, I've only been playing two games on this thing. The first game is Pokemon Go. I played that for 5 days, and after 5 days, I was like, yeah, I can waste my time further in Pokemon Go, but I can also spend my time in other games, which I have. And I decided to stop playing Pokemon Go. It's a major upgrade from any 3DS Pokemon Go, but that's no wonder because a 3DS has this size screen, 240 pixels, and now on the Switch it's this size. It's 1280 by 720 handheld mode, you know, and I'm not gonna dock it. I'm playing handheld, man. This is my handheld. So, hey, that's the first game I started up, and it looks great, man. But Pokemon Go isn't a spin-off. So it's not a real Pokemon. And am I gonna buy Pokemon Shield or Shield or Ball or Blue or whatever? I'm not sure. It feels Pokemon at the moment feels like I'm wasting my time. I played it too much. So Pokemon Go, yeah. So I played that for 5 days. And after 5 days I plugged in another game. And I'll talk about that later when we come to it. Because that's a complete ramble. Let's go to the one more time. Like yesterday. Let's do it one more time. Talk about the games that I bought. And yeah, let's try to do it more efficient. Well, we'll do it. It'll go as it go. The first game. It's on alphabetically order. A to Z. So it's not on date when I bought it. Here's the first one. I'll try to do this all over again. First one is Disgaea 5 by Nippon Ichi Software. It's the complete edition. So you got all the DLC that has been released on the PlayStation. So if I ever want to play Disgaea again, I can do it on a handheld that I love. I bought this game because I bought another game online. And they said, well, you can get free shipping if you pay 25 euros. If you buy another game with a worth of 25 euros, you get free shipping. And shipping was just 4 euros. So to not spend those 4 euros on shipping, I said, okay, add Disgaea 5 for me. At least when I want to play it. I never completed a single Disgaea. I love it. But halfway, I'm like, oh my God, I'm just grinding here to get through the story. And I don't know. But it's still Disgaea. So if I can ever get the urge again. Then another Nippon Ichi. Wow. Yeah, Nippon Ichi. Hey. I'm not the biggest fan of Nippon Ichi. I watched their latest show. On YouTube. It's Nippon Ichi. It's different than Atlus. Let's say it's Nippon Ichi. So, but this one is Fallen Legion. Let's see if I can make at least the sound should be okay. Now that I can't improve the webcam. Fallen Legion, also for the Switch. I watched some videos on YouTube, and it reminded me when I watched, because I haven't played this. I haven't played a single thing yet. It reminded me of this game a bit. Dragon Crown. That was for the, at least for the Vita, I think for the PlayStation 4 as well. It reminded me of that game. A bit the battle system. A sideway fighting. But this is the Nippon Ichi way, of course. So I would have bought that game for 60 euros. It wasn't 60. So I bought that as well. Oh, that's one more thing I didn't mention in the last video. For me, it's a handheld, and Nintendo struggled here, because, hey, if I want to buy a game new for the 3DS, it's 40, you know, $40 or 40 euros. But now for the 3DS, they're like, hey, it's a console, you gotta pay 60. So I gotta pay 50% more for the game. They look 100% more better, I understand. But they struggled. They're like, hey, now we can lose 60 euros. For people who, even if you only want to play it on handheld mode, you're paying more, 50% more. But it is, but I love the thing, so. Nippon Ichi again. They're on a roll. this is imported from the US, the game story in the Netherlands. This game hasn't been released in Europe. What a shame. Yeah, digitally, but hey, keep your digital. If you like digital, go ahead, man. But not for me. So I could buy this for the same price, imported from the US, flown to the Netherlands, to the game store, then shipped to me, and it's the same price that I could buy digital. You know, so digital is such a, to my opinion, such a scam. I'm gonna play the heck out of this, but not today, because I'm still playing another game. Touhou Gensu Wanderer, look at that art. I watched the review, and I will try to include something on this tweet today. I will try. Touhou Gensu Wanderer Reloaded, Nippon Ichi Software again. It's a mystery dungeon game, and I'm meh about mystery dungeon games. And so, but I wanted to have a mystery dungeon, and now I got it on. And I got this yesterday in the mail here, and that's the same day that Chocobo Mystery Dungeon has been released digitally. It's, so that's the competition for mystery dungeon games, but only digital in America and Europe. So we didn't get a physical copy of Chocobo Mystery Dungeon. PlayAsia has a physical copy with English. You can select Japanese or English, and that's only 40 euros. The same price I have to pay for a digital copy. The only problem with PlayAsia is I gotta pay 25 euros for shipping. So if I want to play Chocobo Mystery Dungeon Hunter or some whatever, it's gonna cost me 65 euros, but I prefer that than paying 40 for a digital. So I'm gonna check out PlayAsia. We'll talk about that later. So if you like Mystery Dungeon, there's somebody on YouTube who reviewed this game, and after watching that review, I bought it. I was like, hey, I want it. Well, the art is great. Ooh, that was a little bit loud. The art is great, and there's crafting and all kind of stuff. Awesome. Then, from a company I never heard about until I investigated this game and the game they released before that. A physical copy of Lost Sphere by Square Enix, but it's from Tokyo RPG Factory, and they are the people who also made I Am Setsuna, but they did release this physical here in the West, but not I Am Setsuna. So if I'm gonna contact PlayAsia for Chocobo Mystery Dungeon Hunter, the shipping cost is 25 euros anyway, so include I Am Setsuna with it. So I have, but I'll think about it. Now this game I'm looking forward to. I saw many. at least you can understand now what I'm saying, because last time that audio was so bad, man. Mercenaries Saga Chronicles. It's Final Fantasy Tactics, that style, and it looks almost as it. Hey, there's nothing better than Final Fantasy Tactics, but this looks almost as good as Final Fantasy Tactics, and it's made by. I can't even read it, man. I don't care. It's made by somebody, but it's not Square Enix. And like that's what I said in the last video. If there was Square Enix here, everybody would say, "Hey, man, it's the new Final Fantasy Tactics, a new series. Get it." And this game is 15. Euros or $15, not even on sale price on the digital game store. So if you like Final Fantasy Tactics, and if you like a Switch, try Mercenary Saga Chronicles. Man, the physical edition, yeah, it was double the price. But like I said, and this was also imported. Yeah, this was the second import. This was also imported from the US by the NetGame. Well, I bought it from them, so I can expect it to be a bit. It can't be 15 euros when it's an import game. So we didn't get this in Europe, but you guys, you guys in the US always say, get the most physical copies from everything. There is an exception, I know. So yeah, try it out. It's Final Fantasy Tactics. I want to give it a try. I don't know. Yeah, another Square Enix. This isn't. I thought this was Tokyo Factory. But it isn't, right? It's somebody else then. Ah, well, I don't care. This game made me. Well, Xenoblade made me decide to buy a Switch. And I was like, yeah, if it's only Xenoblade and Zelda, why should I buy a Switch, you know? But so I tried checking on YouTube what games are there. This game also made me decide, hey, I want that Vita. And it is Octopath Traveler. I think it looks a little bit like Bravely Default, right? I think maybe it's the same developers as Bravely Default. I looked the art style, and what people are praising this into heaven and above, even above. I mean, this. I want to play this as well. Octopath Traveler. That's one. Like I said, one of the reasons I bought the Switch, and everything, the design, the turn-based combat system. Maybe there's something with 8 people, and you got to play each story, and it's. I got to check it out. Which people I want to play first? Yeah, this is everybody should support games like this. Send Square Enix the message that hey, we want games like this. We don't game. We don't got. Yeah, okay, yeah. Final Fantasy 15, you're always gonna win in sale numbers, but we also want games like this. Let me say it. So Octopath Traveler, yeah, I can't wait. Pikachu, yeah, I already talked about this one, right? It's Pokemon, bit different. You don't have to capture monsters. Yeah, you got to capture them, but you don't have to fight them. You throw a ball and you capture them. But the rest is a bit the same. The battle system is still good. It looks so awesome on a high definition screen. You still have to fight the trainers, of course, and the people in the world. So it's another step up graphically. But I spent too much. I don't think I can ever enjoy. Well, enjoy, but complete a Pokemon again. That's not. Now the game. Another game I want to play. But the list is this long. I don't have time to play everything. So I'm just gonna take my time. And like I said earlier, on the PC I can't play anything anymore on the PC. What is it? Cyberpunk. But the rest is all going for Epic Store. So the PC is a bit done at the moment. So now, well, here, I got hours and hours and days and weeks of games on the Switch now. So, at the moment I'm like, okay, I'll just wait a year for Epic Store. For the game to come to stream, I mean. The next game. That game made me buy a 360. That was this game, Odyssey, and Blue Dragon. So two of those games are from Mistwalker, who also made Xenoblade. Lost Odyssey, Blue Dragon, and that was, let me check. Yeah, and Magna Carta, but I never played it on. Let's say those three. Those three games made me buy a 360. And I bought it used. I'm like, hey, I'm not going to buy a new 360 just for those three games. And it's still working. That thing is still working. No red light of death or whatever. Like I said, but this game made me buy it. And then I found out about Lost Odyssey and Blue Dragon. And they were, wow. Mistwalker, they are champions in RPGs. They are. They are, trust me. I mean, Lost Odyssey, that's one of the best stories I ever played. Blue Dragon, it's totally different, but Blue Dragon was awesome, man. I love Blue Dragon. And this game. Yeah, man, hey. Tales of Vesperia. But now it's a definitive edition, so we'll get maybe two two more heads, you know, stuff like that. But it's definitive. It's got all the stuff, and I want to replay this game so bad, but I don't have the time at the moment. It's from the era when Tales games were still Tales game, to my opinion. The side scrolling. I love the battle system. Abyss is my favorite. You still know? Abyss is my favorite. A shame it never got released here in Europe, so I had to play it on other means. And I have Abyss here for the 3DS, but I'm not gonna play it on 240p pixel screen. That's not how I'm gonna play Abyss. So if I ever gonna play Abyss again, it's gonna be on the Switch. I hope someday, or PlayStation ever, whatever. I love that battle system, and this one too. This is the old days. I love the art style of these games. Tales games have drifted away from what they were, to my opinion, and that's the same with Final Fantasy. It's such a shame. They drifted away, and maybe that's because I'm getting older, and they are getting a new market of people who are playing games. And yeah, that's what happens. I mean, so once again, Tales of Vesperia. Oh man, I can't wait. I want to replay that game. Nippon Software again. And I wanted to have a dungeon crawler. And actually, there are not many dungeon crawlers for the Vita yet. Let's hope. Not including those mystery dungeon, you know, real dungeon crawler, like Etrian Odyssey, you know, that kind of stuff. And I was like, okay, well, and it's another game that isn't full priced. I mean, I wouldn't have bought it for €60. Never. Nippon-ishi, The Lost Child. Looks interesting. Like I said in the last video, I'm just going to repeat it. Whatever. If this game is a 9, then this game is a 7. You know, it's not top notch. It is Nippon-ishi. But it looked interesting, so Lost Child, if I ever want a dungeon crawl on the Switch, I can do it with that game. This game, yeah. Love-hate, a little bit. I haven't played this one, but love-hate with the first one. It's Valkyria Chronicles 4. Yeah. I never could complete or enjoy the first one, and that was one of the... I'm not going to talk about 2 and 3, because I heard 2 and 3 were rubbish. The first one was, there was always an objective, like a complete this map in 2 turns. If you want the that bonus. I hope they removed that from 4. I hope I can play 4 on my on my terms, you know. If I want to play a level and take 2,000 turns, please don't punish me for it, man. Hey, I know you want to drive me a bit. But don't punish me, like not giving me rewards I would have gotten when I completed the map in 3 turns. If it is, then it's going to be another disappointment. But it looks so great, man. I mean, the idea of this game, everything, it's turn-based and it's 3D and you can shoot and the story should be awesome. So I'm going to give this game a try one day, Valkyria Chronicles 4. And now the game I'm playing at the moment. And let's start with showing you this game. This game. Xenoblade Chronicles 2. Look at that. It doesn't... If you haven't played the game, the cover doesn't do you much. But it does... I'm still playing it. The cover is also... Xenoblade Chronicles 2. And I'm glad I stepped in the Switch this year. Because what did those wonderful people at Mistwalker, there are some companies like Atlus, I totally respect, but Mistwalker, man, they earned my respect over the years. Like Atlus, by the way, as well. What did they do? They made a season pass. And I know where we're going with it. I don't like season passes. I mean, it's all for the money. You get a piece of clothing. And that's season pass one. But let's not start there. What did those guys do? They made a season pass. But included in the season pass is a 40-hour story that takes place before Xenoblade 2. So it's a complete, it's basically a complete game by itself, and it's called Torna. And that's included in the season pass. So if you buy the season pass digitally for Xenoblade Chronicles 2, you also get that expansion. And it's an expansion like Witcher 3, you know. It's not like two missions which take 3 minutes each. No, it's a complete new world. And it takes place before Xenoblade Chronicles 2. And what these awesome people do, they made it a physical copy. And they called it the Torna. Well, that's the world, that's the expansion. Xenoblade Chronicles 2, Torna. They made it physical. How awesome. And when you buy this, I didn't know, when you buy the expansion, you'll get the season pass stuff. All the season pass for Xenoblade Chronicles 2 is included when you buy the physical copy of. So you don't have to buy it digitally, the season pass. You can buy it physical and you have everything as well. And that's how this is how I like season pass done well. It's physical. You get a 40-hour, basically, it's a new game. It's at least a new story that takes 40 hours plus. And if you play this game, you know where this story will go. And it will explain a lot of stuff that happened before this in this. So it's physical, it's a season pass, it's a 40-hour expansion. This is a season pass done well. It's the second game I put in my Switch, and I haven't taken it out. I'm still playing Xenoblade Chronicles 2. I'm now over 100 hours in, and I'm chapter 6 out of 10. And after 10, I still... Let me stop the video here, because the phone is ringing. And we're back for part 2. Now, where was I? Probably at Xenoblade Chronicles 2. It was quite a long phone call, so I'm totally out of the zone again. So Xenoblade Chronicles 2, I haven't stopped playing it yet. It is... is it as good as the first one? I can make a complete ramble video about Xenoblade Chronicles 2 one of these days, probably when I finished it. Yes and no. The battle system is even more amazing than one. That's the positive. In most RPGs, the thing you're doing most is battling. And battling has become better, to my opinion. I think it's totally worth it, this game. Xenoblade Chronicles 2. Monolith Games, man. Oh, yeah. And one more game I bought. That wasn't all. Just one more. I bought this game for when my Vita is recharging. Because, like I said, I play it in handheld mode. And the recharge cable is on the bottom side of the Switch. So, basically, I can't... Well, recharging is not that much of an option while I'm playing in handheld mode. So I can play 3 hours and then it really needs to recharge. So I was like, I want to play something else while the Switch is recharging. And I can't play on the Switch because it's recharging. So I bought one more game and it's for a handheld. Probably this is going to be the last game I'm going to buy for the 3DS. And that's this game. Radiant Historia, but this is the perfect chronology. Let me try one more time. Perfect chronology, and it's a bit upgraded version from the DS. And so I'm trying to because I didn't quite enjoy the first one. So while my Vita is recharging, I keep playing, keep naming it Vita. While my Switch is recharging, I'm playing now Radiant Historia, and it's not a bad game, but it's not Xenoblade. But it's not a bad game. Now the last part, and then it's gonna be over. Let's mention 4 games I bought digitally on this. What an amazing handheld it is. I bought digitally Earthlock. Earthlock looks very interesting. This game is not being released physical, and it was on sale, and most of the time then it's €15 or something. Earthlock looked very interesting. Child of Light. Now talking about light, I need my lighter, so I'm just gonna try to continue rambling. Yeah, Child of Light, it's a game I bought for Steam on the PC. I bought it on another console, which I don't remember which one. I think it was the Vita. And now I bought Child of Light on the Switch as well. I can play it now in full HD on the Switch. That developer deserves the support, man. It's an awesome game, Child of Light. And the amazing part is it's released by Ubisoft. And it's the only game that is interesting from Ubisoft released the last 20 years. So Child of Light, I bought it. So I can play it now on the Vita as well, if I want to, one day, maybe. Another looking very interesting game, Magic Scroll Tactics. Also only digital, looked very interesting, it wasn't expensive. It's a bit side-scrolling tactical RPG, so it's not like Final Fantasy Tactics where you have a world, but this is side-scrolling, and a turn-based strategy RPG looked very interesting, and not that expensive either. And the last game digitally I bought, The Flame in the Flood. And that's not a GRPG, it's some kind of survival-y game. We have to cook food and drink water, and a great story. Looked, the graphics, it's not a 6 teraflops game, but it looked, the art style looked great, and it's some kind of survival game. And it wasn't expensive either. So I bought that one as well, and I put one game that has been released yesterday on my wishlist. And I'm gonna buy that. That's gonna be eight. I think next week. It's only €8 or $8. And that's, how can you release this game for $8? Let's see how it's called. Azure Saga. And it's now 15% off because it has been released the 21st. That was yesterday. It looks a Azure Saga. Not even €8 or $8. Well, that game looks awesome as well. So Azure Saga, I'm definitely gonna pick up as well digitally, because there's no physical copy. And how can you make that game for €8? I can't believe it. And it's very interesting look. Totally interesting. And that's the ramble. That's my Switch. I think I'm gonna hide the old video. I'm not gonna delete it, but hide it. I'm gonna call this one a remastered HD audio edition or something. We'll see how it goes. But I'm glad I got the audio fixed, man. That it was horrible, eh? If you watched the video from yesterday. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the content. If you do, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, thumbs down. But then, I don't think this channel is for you. If you didn't like this content, then this is me. So thank you for watching, at least if you're still watching. Like I mentioned in yesterday's video, greetings to Whisper Ocean, Atticus MJ, Padoka, Celluloid, all the people I mentioned for the video yesterday. Solution 66, Christopher Richardson, Padoka, of course, Christopher Ross, thank you again. I mentioned that yesterday, but I'm sure nobody heard it because audio was so bad. Thank you again for sending me Legends of Heroes back, way back for the PlayStation Portable. I never forgot that, man. Thank you very much. Anthony Jenkins, Super Vega 25 Returns, Terrison and Machiavelli, man, you also awesome guys. Thank you very much for watching and leaving a comment. And I definitely will see each other again. It's not going to be a daily. I'm not going to upload daily. So check out Ethicus MJ streams on Switch, Twitch. I'll see you there. Mostly when he's streaming, I'm there. I love his content. So yeah, maybe see you there. And otherwise, back on one of these videos. Have a great day. Have a great evening. Have a great week. And see you next time. Bye-bye from Kyler.